I'd like to share to you this lesson. It is a personal devotion of mine in the recent days. Ti paulo na kakabsat kat how to reach and possess your promised land. How to reach and possess your promised land. Agkararag tayo kakabsat. Dear Lord, we ask for your blessing. Takadaiti ko mga message. We can glean wisdom and understanding. Ngamangtad kada kami, Apo, iti nananay nga panakaiturong, dagiti pampanunot, dagiti aramid mi, nang runa, Apo, ting kami panagservi ken ka. We are facing another week leading to the year end. Coming up 2021, moving adu dagiti promises mo nga maragpat mi di 2021 by your grace. So, dayti nga lesson should give us wisdom and idea. Da kuma may sa dua wano talo dito yung apunto nga tumatak kada kami Apo nga ma-relate mi iti panagbiag mi personal kan kadagiti pamilya mi itang amalim. That's my prayer, Lord. In Jesus' name, Amen. Naggapuan na dito term nga promised land. It's being used today by corporate world, by businesses, by people that talk about success and prosperity. Ngayon, that word nga promised land has been taken from the Bible in the Old Testament, the land of Canaan. While the Israelites have been in Egypt for more than 400 years as slaves, hanga nalipatan ti Apo ti Karina kini Abraham, nga dayto ket maysa nga land, prosperous land, and the Lord will bless them in that land. After more than 400 years, God remembered His promise to Abraham, raised up a man by the name of Moses, and Moses led the nation of Israel, walked through the wilderness, and finally reached the promised land. But there are many lessons we can learn from time to time. This DJ na paspasama kakabsat iti wilderness. Now, what does promised land speak for us today? Anat meaning namot kada tayo? Ayah. At adigiti Israelite kat napanda di promised land da. So anamot ti meaning na kadatay di promised land? Well, there are at least three that I could share with you. Una, promised land speaks of God's purpose and desire for you. Amen. Di plano ti Apo ti biag mo. So datay nga naganak, kunati kadigiti anak tayo, anak ko, ada promised land ti Apo para gan ka. Ada insagana na, ada intuding na nga para gan ka. So nga hangkang agapapura, hangkang gangganat. Okay? Hankang tawag dito, agbakbakslide. Because God has a purpose and desire for your life. Amen. Secondly, promised land speaks of God's blessings reserved for you. God's blessings reserved for you. So, awan tayo pa ikakabsat, iti future ngayon agururay yan agasam deta kakabsat. Ah, agururay gaya man, digiti blessings ti Apo iti masakbayan ng aldaw. Okay? Thirdly, promised land refers to the full potential of your service to God. Amen. The full potential ti panagserbim iti Apo. For me, dito yung panagpastor ko, promised land ko dito eh. Dito yung nga ma-experience ti abundance of the grace of God in my life. Han nga in terms of material man lang, no dikat in many, many aspects, nga dito yung nga calling, nga sinurot ko, dito'y ko nga mapadasan iti abounding grace of God. Kastamot king ka. No surutan mo't di plano ti Apo ti biag mo, no surutan mo't dayjay pangiturungan na ka, dayjay ti promised land mo nukuan. Dayjay mo nga ma-experience, dayjay abounding grace iti Apo iti biag mo. Ngayon ti question tayo ti dayti nga malem is, how can we reach and possess that promised land? How can we fulfill the purpose of God? Asan no tayo nga maragpat, digiti nga blessings nga in reserve ti Apo for us? How can we reach the full potential of our service to the Lord? Now, dito yung message can be viewed in another way. Mabaling nga kastoy kakabsat in a form of a question. Mabaling nga kuna tayo, why the Israelites failed to reach the promised land? Now, not all of them entered the land. In fact, ti nakastrict lang nun kakabsat kut jay second generation. To the exception of Joshua and Caleb. Jay muna nga generation nga naggapo jay Egypt, all of them hanga nakastrict the promised land. Sorry to say, hanga nakastrict the promised land. Okay? Even Moses was not able to enter the promised land. They walked through the wilderness, they experienced that the goodness ti Apo Diyay, ngemdi da nakadanon ije promised land. So why? Apay nga takakabsat? So makita tayo kadigiti points, i-reflect tayo, tibiyag tayo, reflection, ti dayti nga malim, I hope pagkaroon tayo ti realization, anyada digiti makaiga po, nga hantay maragpat, dayjay plano ti Apo tibiyag tayo. Sayang mo't ayaw kakabsat, nga nagbiag ka for many, many years, ngayon hamun experience, di promise lang ti Apo itibiyag mo. Sayang met, di ba? So, let me share to you, mga kapatid, four reasons why a part of the Israelites did not reach the land and why only two from that generation reached that land. Now, how to reach and possess your promised land? Would you like to know? Runa ka, dagay nga yung people, nakamaymayat. Di ito'y medyo kaslang dramatic iso na nga preaching. Ayang em, just reflect. I hope nga damaglin yung wisdom from here. Okay? Number one, ti may isang reason kakabsat is this. You need to get rid of Egypt in your mind. Get rid of Egypt in your mind. Okay? Di ito'y tattao, numampay nakarwardan manipod si Egypt, Gemti Egypt, hangarim wardi panunod da. All along the way, Egypt has always been in their mind. So, get rid of Egypt in your mind. Now, kada kayong new, anak at deti Egypt, pastor. Okay. Egypt represents the world. Pharaoh represents Satan. So, pag nagdudraw tayo ng picture and application, pag binabasa natin sa Old Testament, Egypt is a picture of what the world system is today. Dito yung nainlubungan nga sistema. It talks about our past life. Diba? Di dati nga biyag tayo idi. So what you need to do, now that you are saved, ahead of you is the promised land. As you pursue, possess, reach your promised land, you need to get rid of Egypt in your mind. Kailangan kakabsat na no kuma baklat uno ulagkat aglupos ka. There are some things that you need to get rid of from your life. Now, in Exodus chapter 16, just an example, verses 1 to 3, and they took the journey from Elim, and all the congregation of children of Israel came unto the wilderness of Sin, which is between Elim and Sinai, on the 15th day of the second month after their departing out of the land of Egypt. So, nakaalis na. 2. And the whole congregation of the children of Israel murmured against Moses and Aaron in the wilderness. Nagrekreklamo da. Apay kakabsat, among kami no at the exposure mo iti Egypt, kat adda ka iti Christian life, mariknam di pa nagreklamo at nagbaliwan eh. Di dati ayon ko, hindi kat may mayat, dati ay sitwasyon ko itakat, apay kastuyen. And the children of Israel said unto them, would to God, akunada, we had died by the hand of the Lord in the land. Di pa lang di Egypt kam nga natay, di kunada. Oh, di ba? When we sat by the flesh pots, and when we did eat bread to the full, for ye have brought us forth into this wilderness to kill this whole assembly with hunger. Di ba? Nakarwardan di Egypt, ngem di mind da kakabsat, at da pelang di Egypt iday. Kaya't nang asawin, no adala ko matchance dang nagsubli ka kabsat, nagsiwak man ko madidye Red Sea, talaga nga nagsubli da. Ngayon kaputa, siyempre, alangan mo't nagsubli da, pagsiwakan daman di Red Sea, how can they do that, di ba? So wala na eh. No chance of return. Ngayon no kumalang siguro that chance na kakabsat, nagsubli da. So God said, I cannot take you to my promised land because Egypt is still in your mind. Oh. Tataka kabsat, Numbers 11. Di, eto na, medyo malapit-lapit na sila. Numbers 11. And the mixed multitude that was among them fell a lasting. Not lasting, nag-derup da. And the children of Israel also wept again and said, who shall give us flesh to eat? Et mit mangan di karne. Kunada. Verse next. We remember the fish. And which we did eat in Egypt freely, the cucumbers and the melons and the leeks and the onions and the garlic. Apokot may tisang audaga kabsa na ta onion kada garlic ka. But now our soul is dried away. There is nothing at all beside this manna. Before, makaumamot, dito yung puro manna. Minsan, bilang Kristiyano, malaglagip mo, tibiyag mo, hindi unsaved ka, di ba? Aglalalo no kasto yung kuagat, apo, malaglagip ko lahat, biyag ko, di unsaved ako. Magpaidi, tanaragrag sa akak. Enjoy, enjoy, biyag ko, hindi. Bakit ngayon ganito? So, handa maawatan, DJ Rick na, iti sumurot ti apo, because at the Egypt kakabsat, iti mindset ng amin. So, Egypt represent worldly ways. Many Christians fail to know and fulfill God's will in their life because they are a slave of worldliness in their mind. At ako man, ti Pilipinas kakabsat, aging gana ita, ti makailapod. Amuyot may isang adak, kailang makailapod. Ala, ti pa nagprogreso ti Pilipino kakabsat, gaputa at dapelang di influence iti Spanish kada tayo. Kasano ko makakabsat nga rod nga umunsad ti Pilipinas kat adamot ta man niya na habit? De ta kakabsat, anat man niya na habit? Tuta, damdama. Oh, de ta kakabsat kat lack of discipline. Ala, sometimes adapel, etang ugali tayo, di nga men? Dayje pa nang itong tungkwa tayo kakabsat, aduntun iti, iramraman nan, nga consequence. So, we are far from what we are supposed to be because deti colonialism mentality, we are still slaves of the Spaniards today. Oh, deta kang kanayon nga i-preach ni Pastor Jun Nua, kasano nga umunsat di Pilipinas kat anak kakabsat, deta always late. Kat talaga kakabsat, amuyo kano, digit Espanyol, digit Spain, talaga, always late. Ustunto ta oras, ustunto, parang ganon. E kat di Amerika kakabsat kat on time. So, dakkel iti may, dakkel a factor ti pro pa nagprogreso. Deta, panang observe, iti oras, di nga ming kakabsat. Anapa iti na ibati iti Espanyol kada tayo, crab mentality. Ano di crab mentality kakabsat? That you do not want to see your fellow, you know, grow. Umangat. Di kahit isuna nga umangat. So, what do? Guyudem, pagpangalam isuna, tapno si kati umangat, agiginuyod nga agpababa. All of this, matagal nang walang Spanish regime sa Pilipinas, pero hanggang ngayon, slaves pa rin tayo sa Espanyol. And because of this, narigat kakabsat, di pa nagprogreso ti Pilipino, mapukaw itinapintas nga disiplina. So in that note, mga kapatid, as God's people, hantayo nga aggrow ti panagserbi ti Apo, hantay nga agadvance iti Christian life tayo, no hantay nga maiwaksi, dagiti worldly habits ti biag tayo. So the day lesson ko itatay iti, why we find trouble knowing the will of God. Ti may sa day kakabsat, adada pet sins tayo. Uno da digiti worldly habits, kasi ti Apo, ti kayat na sold out. Okay? So, that is number one, get rid. Kaya ang aking tanong sa atin ngayong hapon is, what are some worldly habits and worldly things in your life that you need to get rid right now? Tapnon sold out ka nga talaga nga para tiya po. Are you sold out for God? Oh, you know what the Lord will do? Tesan na ka tiya po. Subukan na ka tiya po. God has always been doing that. You know that? Oh, na-mention ko itay ni Abraham, anat inaramid niya po Diyos. The promise is clear. I'll bless you, I'll make thee a great nation. Tatan na yanak ni Isaac, isuna ti agbalin nga seed to fulfill the promise. Suddenly, God said, give me your son. Tinesti apo. E kunana, siguro nuhan na willing ni Abraham kakabsat, hana natuloy di nga promise. Awang kuma di promise land. So kakabsat, tesan na kati apo. O, isong amuyo, dito cheerful giving. Hala nga di number one, itad tayo kasi ayatan tayo ti apo. Ngayon pa ng proof ti apo kakabsat, di ayat tayo kengkwana. To prove the sincerity of our love. Kaya mo tasukatan ti Apo, deta apay kiddi nga saan? In fact, ni Abraham kat, he trusted God, nga kunana kat, uray kat batay ni Isaac kat, apay di kat kaya nga pagbiyagan ti Apo kunana. So nga, natalgad, nga nangidaton kakabsat, to the point nga patayin na pa yan ni Isaac. So brethren, if you are going to reach the promised land God has for us, masapola sold out ti panunod tayo, ti puso tayo, talaga nga, anyaman na kaya ti Apo nga iwaksi tayo, iwaksi tayo. Amen. And you know what? Even as I speak this right now, ambok na ti Holy Spirit kasarita na ka ti Apo. At ipakita ti Apo king ka. nga masapul nga iwaksim iti panagbiag mo. Number two, secondly, okay? For us to reach the promised land, lesson from the life of the Israelites, number two, obey God's leading and instructions. Obedience is the key. Amen? Kung nanonog, lako kagat, PM is the key. Kung nanonog, di kamin, nag-post ka ti, lakom yan ta, Facebook kat, PM is the key. Kung nanonog, di ba? O, deti mo't promised land, obedience is the key. Panagtulnog itiapo. Amen? So, tatakakabsat, as far as obedience is concerned, ti pakita ka da kay didoy, kakabsat, several things. Letter A, there was an easy route to the promised land. Han namat kailangan nga ijay kuma dito'y Red Sea sa atidog kami dito'y the shortcut na actually kakabsat. But had they taken that route, none of them would have made it because they were not ready for the fight. So dito'y panangilid ti apo kadakwara di wilderness kakabsat numampay delay, but it was God's way to prepare them. So in your life, mabalin nga adada di gijay, pangilidan ti apo ti biyag mo, you feel like it's a delay. But the Lord is just preparing your life. So agtulnog kalatagin kwa na, agtalag kalata ti apo. Amen? Marutaw mong Carlo. O, 31. Uray mga 10 years pa, sakbay nga kasawa ka kaya. Okay? Madelay. Adagururay nga promised land mo, Carlo. Amen? Promised land. Oh, di ba? Puuni ragsak ni Brother Carlo nga nakaamong adagayang promised land na. Dagagabsat. Di ito ikat ililid lang ti apo, isagsagana lang ti apo, tibiyag na. So, malagip yun tumutibiyag yun. Ah, dahil hindi ko na ni pastoron nga wilderness experience tibiyag ko. Okay? The Lord is leading me here. Medyo maitantan nga maitantan. Di plano ti apo. Agan-ano saklata nga ang sumuro ti apo, ang serbiya klata ti apo, agan anus kalata kakabsat, ang tulnog kalata ti apo. Letter B, they had the pillar of cloud and fire. In a very amazing way, they had the pillar of cloud and fire. Now, that the pillar of cloud, nagserbi iso na nga shade by day. Amen. They jemot pillar of fire, they ngatuan da kakabsat, nagserbi nga silaw by night. Now, digiti nga pillars kakabsat, isut guiding factor da dito. Isut kasla navigator da kakabsat. Isut ti GPS da. Kasi every time nga move, they move. But when it stops, they pitch their tent. So, isut GPS da dito. Kat kakabsat, ti GPS tayo, dito yung Word of God. So, gusto di naramid ni Nico, through the year, binasa na ti Bible. So, awan ti aldaw nga dito yung basat Bible. Awan aldaw nga dito yung devotion. Hante palabsin tilawas nga dito yung mga ganda giti preaching the Word of God because di gijay ko timely nga panangisuro, panangitid, tiapo ti instruction. Dito ti lesson tayo di Wednesday night. Direction. Amen? E kat di pa nagdingding ngagmuti sa utiapo. Arat mapasamag, ikan na ka tiapot idea. Mayit man di preaching ni pastor, nagkaroon na ti idea. O di ba? Tsaka mo ipag-pray, Lord, aramidit nga rodeti nga banag. Naranasan nyo na ba yun? Nga di pa nagdingding yung preaching, nagkaroon kay ti idea. Habang dingding, kakat, imututukam di message, kat, ting ko na, nagat, nagkaroon na ti idea, nasungbatan ti sa lodsod ko, excited kang agawi dun, di ba? Kasi, naadaan kat idea ka, DJ preaching. Letter C, God uses His servants to teach you His instruction. Usarun ti apo kakabsat, dagiti adipon na, pastors. Amen? Iso nga, masapul nga ibilang tayo digiti pastors nga partner tayo kakabsat. Iti amin nga endeavors iti panagbiag tayo. Importante dayjay ha, let's consider our pastors as partners. Kaya't madaydayo ti apo kakabsat na napintas pa nakaisuro na kadatay dito yung abanag. Diba? Doon da digiti plano tayo paggapte nga panagnegosyo, pastor, ikararag mo man dito yung plano. You know, we can give some advice if we can. But if not, then we can pray for you. Abaling at ikararag mi kat Lord, i-guide mo dahil ting kakabsat, put a hedge of protection around him, ikanawam ti panagkamalina, iturong mo apo ti dapat nga panagturong itibiyag na Lord. Okay? But God uses His servant. So, nang runa ka dagay ngayang people, iruam yu ti biyag yu nga makikommunicate iti pastor. Importante dayjay. Makikommunicate kayo. Oh, Egat urayek kakabsat nga dagi communicate kanyak ti grade na. Ha, awampay, nagidanon ti grade na. Awampay, awampay grade yo? Ay, awampay nga men. O, kanon tong adda? Into no January taon. O, masapul nga ipakita yun to't pastor, di kiti grade yo, ah. Pakita yun to kadagam kong Pastor John. Ah, o, pastor, deto ito grade me. Deto ito grade ko, pastor. Ah, blessing ta, medyo nasidap ti matak ka, nagsakar ngamin ka deto. Copy-paste. Oh, di ba? But inform your pastor, those are small matters, but you are now establishing a wonderful connection. Of the many connection, nang runa kat tibiyag tayo kat, as we move to the future, kat importante connection. Deta ti maysa nga dapat i-establish mo. Partner mo ti pastor mo, kadigiti endeavors ti panagbiag mo. Establish your connection with your pastor. Di ba? Oh, expand your social connection ko natin nukwa. Invest on social connection because you never know. Baka deta kinawayam lang nga, hi, kung kunam kat, agbalinto mo ta congressman ti Ilocos Norten. Oh, tunuwapan ko masidig kat, congressman, I remember you. Kinawayan nak tinaminsan, hangka nalipatan eh. Kasi deta lang ang kat nakalalagip. Di ba? Oh, just you have to expand your connection. And as young people, deta, na isa nga dapat i-establish you. Ah, deta connection you iti pastor. You communicate. Pastor, ipag-pray, planok ti ag-shift. Oh, just tell your pastor. Pastor, kaslang ready aksan nga agasawa ko namo na no mabalin ng Edward ayan ha ready kan Edward o hampay o kat manut taw mo ka din 20 o 10 years pa ay pauna ang pera ni Carlo no nagasawang Carlo mayat kan tumut nga agasawan okay kada kay nga young professionals amok nga busy kayo ng Hanyo nga, dete ibilang kakabsat nga rigatan nga makikonek kay nga makikonek ti pastor. Apay, di mo kat kayat nga isunag at digijay turungom kan planom kat ikararag ti pastor. Di ba? O, nangruna kin ni Pastor Jun. Eh, kat iso ti everyday nga ministry na dete kakabsat to pray and pray and pray. Di ba? Mamaya, after ng service, you can go to him. Pastor, ada plano ka kastoy. Pastor, ipag-prayo. Lagi na ni John Paul na i-mention nat na minsan, di promotion. Na-promote kan? Awampay. Awampay? O, updatean na ito, ano? O, anat update di promotion mo, ha? Ma-promote, dedi nga absat, superintendent. Ha? O, 5 years, 10 years from now. Palubos ti Apo. Promise land. Ha? Kasi, kadagam nga pastor, ti Joy Mimit, kadag prosper kayo ka absat. Di ba? Tapno i-update mi muti kararag miti Apo ah. That's our joy. That's our that your joy will also be our joy. Absat. Di kam nga maragsakan no aming kayo nga young people ket sagegay sakay tukot sing umay makigimong ka absat. Amen. Oh, puro ana, puro BMW. Oh, angam jekot set pastor Mercedes Benz. Okay? But it's our joy. That the Lord will prosper. In fact, that is our prayer. The prayer of Jabez. Lord, bless them. Enlarge their coast. Your hand be upon them. Keep them away from evil. Kakabsat. So sana ma-realize you deta ita. Ti importance ti adipon ti Apo di life you. Ayan. Okay? Ganon din sa Israel eh. Yung role ni Moses, napakahalaga. On the other hand, kakabsat, di letter D, those that rebelled against Moses died tragically. Ito yung Numbers chapter 16, 31 to 33. Tignan natin ang nangyari. And it came to pass, as he had made an end of speaking all these words, that the ground clave asunder that was under them. Imagine that. Nagringyat ti lupa, daga. And the earth opened her mouth. Dagayam ngiwat kakabsat ti daga. Ayan. And swallowed them up and their houses and all the men that appertain unto Korah and all their goods. They and all that appertain to them went down alive into the pit and the earth closed upon them and they perished them. Digiti nga tattao kakabsat, ha? Tinaramid dangamin in suggest da kini Aaron since ni Moses at the Mount Sinai. In suggest da kuna da ano ni Moses garamit tay ti gods tayon. Nalagip da job ubra da di Egypt kakabsat. Ayon. So inimpluwensa anda ni Aaron. So Aaron led the people, brought all their jewelries together and built that golden calf. Pagbaba ni Moses, galit na galit. Pat! Who is on the Lord's side? Kuna ni Moses. Deti kora kundi giti grupo na handa makisang ayon kini Moses. So anat inaramid di apo kakabsat? Pinag-open na ti dagaket inalun-un na ida. Di handa na kadanong di promised land. Kakabsat. Because they did not obey the instruction of the leader. Letter E kakabsat. Under the new leader. Oh, ito na ngayon. Si Joshua naman. Kasi si Moses, han nga nakadanong di promised land, di ba? Oh, tatan ni Joshua, iso nga the book of Joshua, this is the work of God in the life of Joshua, the new leader. Ginawa nila, the new generation of Israelites followed his leadership. Ningan nyo sa tagpindas deti kwa napasamak, okay? Tignan natin ha, sa Joshua chapter 1, 16 to 18. And they answered Joshua, the people told him, saying, all that thou commandest us, we will do. And whithersoever thou sendest us, we will go. Magmayat, di ba? Oh. According as we hearken unto Moses, in all things, so will we hearken unto thee. No kasano nga dimngag kam kini Moses, dinggenda kan tumet. Only the Lord thy God be with thee, as he was with Moses. At dalakot tiapo king ka, sumurot kam king ka kunada. Oh, di ba? Yan. Kaya, whosoever he be that rebel against thy commandment and will not hearken unto the words in all thou commandest, him he shall be put to death. Patayin mi kunada. Only be strong and obey good care. In-encourage na ni Joshua. Tip-tip-kir ka, Sir Joshua. Because we will follow you. As you will follow the Lord. Nakita yung kakabsat? So, obey God's leading. And in obeying God, abda digiti authority nga intid niya po Diyos. Obey them that have the rule over you. Submit yourself, for they watch for your soul. I often appreciate digiti parents at digiti parents nung kwa nga pastor. Ipag-pray man dito anak ko. Pastor, anak may advice mo. Please advise my son. Yun is a blessing kakabsat. Nga as a young pastor, kahit mabalin ko nga maministeran, di giti an-anak yung kakabsat. Amen? That is one of my burden eh. Nga maministerak, di giti young people tayo. Di giti next generation, ma-influensya ang danga para iti apo. So, what is key number two? And why is it that those people did not reach the promised land? Key number two is what? Obey God's leading and instruction. Sino ti key person di giti kakabsat? The servant of God. Digiti adipon ti apo. Number three, how to reach and possess your promised land? Be patient. Deto'y kakabsat, deto'y nagpalyaran ni Moses. Okay? Moses lost his patience. Naibusan ti Anos. Napunuan ngamin. At apo, sino kumamati? Di mapunuan kakabsat, di ba? Di kitang tupay anak tayo no ring-ring-ring-ring ka tapo. Napadasan yung kapsat, dito ay marindi ka. Di ba? Ring-ring-ring-ring. You know, in Numbers chapter 20, 10 to 11, etong nangyari. And Moses and Aaron gathered the congregation together before the rock. Kailangan nila ng tubig. Ito instruction ng Diyos. And he said unto them, hear now ye rebels. Must we fetch you water out of this rock? 11. And Moses lifted up his hand, and with his rod, he smote the rock twice. Bang! Kung nagsardan kayo na eh. Bang! And the water came out abundantly, and the congregation drank, and their beast also. Anat basol ni Moses, di kakabsat. Di ko na nakakabsat, di Deuteronomy 33, kita nyo ah, verse 51. Deuteronomy 33, verse 51. Actually, ni Moses, na emma eh. Kunana, di Bible, he is the meekest man. Ngimhan na na-maintain. Dito yung kakabsat, nag-high blood. Kat DJ pa nag-high blood na isong agananad kayo kakabsat, what's your anger? What's your temper? baka isudeta ti pakailapdan nga marits mo di promise len ti abo. Nag high blood. Because ye trespass against me among the children of Israel at the waters of Meribah, Kadesh, in the wilderness of Zin. Because ye sanctified me not in the midst of the children of Israel. 52. Yet thou shalt see the land before thee, but thou shalt not go thither unto the land which I give unto the children of Israel. Continue. Okay? Wala na? Oh, ang nangyari dyan ganito, ang sabi ng Diyos, speak to the rock. And you know, kapag dipungtot ni Moses kakabsat, nag-high blood, hana na control, dipungtot na, binalo na, pang, namindwapay. But despite of that, still, di ba, bimulwak kakabsat iti danum. So all of these people drank from that rock. All of them were satisfied. Ngayon, hindi kuwan kakabsat, hindi adada di Mount Nebo. Apo, hindi mapangkam kumat Israel ka, hindi kuwan. Research at deto eh. Kasi isot umuna ko mga papanami, Mount Nebo. Deto yung Mount Nebo, dito yung kakabsat nga, inpanda ni Moses, tap numatan nawagan na iti Israel, the land of Canaan. So kung natiapo ni Moses, tanawagam, latang kunana, hangka makastrugan, imagine that. Jay anus na kakabsat, nga nagiturturud, kandangan anus kadigiti ng Israelite, sa isang iglap, nawala yung privilege niya. Iso ang kakabsat, generally, ti pagpakita na dito, what's your self-control, ti important dito. Iso di ko na di Bible, ah, lest I, when I preach to others, I myself become a castaway. Sayang ko na. Masapula, disiplina, aktibagik. So nga, disiplinaan tayo kakabsat, tibagbagi tayo. We must be willing to go through a rigorous discipline. In fact, the word discipline means disciple. Amen? Amen. Oh, madlaw mo nga tibagim, agsulit ka, digiti na espiritwa na banag, mindset, madidete. Apikas to yung agsusulit tiriknak nga para ti Apo, agsusulit tiriknak nagbasa at Bible. Padasan nyo day giant? Imposible nga nyo napadasan kakabsat. Napadasan yun, amen? Well, masulit kay ping agamen ang gutne, di ba? Amen? Agsusulit kay ping agamen ang. Awaan ang kakabsat, ba't matay na digito yan? Okay? Sapul dan sa Dunkin Donut. Oh. Oh, kita, nariingan na siya. Ni Carlo, oh, kuna ni Carlos si pambira. Amen? But, you know, be patient. Isungahan nyo ang underestimated kakabsat, ti power, ti patience. Isu detat mangitong daging kat promised land. Patience is your vehicle that will lead you to your promised land. Baga kung kunam, did you self-control kan patience? So, sumutla kunana di Bible, the trying of your faith work at patience. Look at the next kunana, let patience have her perfect work in you, that she may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. Amen? Oh, so don't lose your patience. Bagamang kadeda ka abay mo, hangka mauawanan ti panaganos ko nam. Agang anus ka latta. Anus ka. Amen? Oh, agang anus tayo kabsat. Okay? Just continue to serve the Lord. You never know. Alright? Oh, how many believers who had the potential to be useful by God in the ministry but are ineffective because they lose their patience? Number four, may ikapat ka kabsat. Overcome your fear. If you're going to reach your promised land, overcome your fear. Masapol kakabsat nga ikatem ti panagkabakabam, panagdanag. Dayjay panagalalangan mo. All of us naturally adaamin pagdanagan tayo kakabsat. Now, deto iti sitwasyonan. Okay. Digito'y nareklamo nga Israelites from Egypt. Nakadaanon da kakabsat ijay eh. Dadadyayan eh, kadwada ni Moses, di Mount Nebo. Doon na sila. Ilang hakbang na lang nasa promised land na sila mga kapatid. Pero itong nangyari. Nagpadala si Moses ng 12 spies. Pagbalik nila, nagbigay ng balita. Sabi nung sampo, awang kaslate lapad dudong. There are giants in the land. Now, Joshua and Caleb said, no, we will go up at once. We are able to overcome it. God is with us. Ngayon, di kito isang apulo kakabsat na discouraged na tipuso, di kito tao. Oh, awana, kunada. Because of their unbelief, kunatiapo, kaanong tunga taaya, maumaakmutan ka, di kito, kunatiapo, maumaakon. So, amuyot na pasama kakabsat, amin digidye nga generation, awan nakastrip di promised land. Pinagsubli in rerot ti Apo ida, 40 years manen nga nagkatang-katang dati wilderness. Aging gana kakabsat nga natay dagiti 20 above, tama? Amin nga 20 years old above natay dan, except kini Joshua ken Caleb. Takunan na di Bible, because they wholly followed the Lord. Oh. So, because of their fear, handa nakastrip di promised land. Inuray da nga naganak, and after those years, you know, digiday 20 years above, natay dan, digiday 20 years below, isudan kakabsat, iti in lead ni Joshua. Isuda, digiday ububing, yang, yang, digiday in lead ni Joshua. Oh. It, alam nyo, this is true, this is real in all aspects of life. A lot of businesses could have been started, but what kept them was fear. Ado kumat business nga napintas, good ideas eh, nairugi ko madigiti nga business, ngayon anat rason na nga na nairugi-rugi, fear. The fear to take the risk. A lot of potentials could have been maximized, but what kept them was fear. Di ba kakabsat? Naling ka kumamutag, gitara ita ng, oh, hangko kaya kung kunan mo dito eh. Oh, naling ka kumamut, nag-preach ita ng, mabaina kung kunan mo. So, awan, hana na develop because of fear. Amen ba mga kapatid? Oh, a lot of Christians could have abounded in the grace of giving, but what kept them was fear. Mabuting, itod ko ti persprut ko, di awan tut mabati kanya ako. Og tight sack, basit tut mabatin, nagpakal ti tights na, agasam no, 20,000 ta sweldom, 2,000 ti tights mo, naglove offering ka pa, nagmission offering ka pa, awan na, awan mabati kanya ako na. Fear. Nakita yung kapsat? So, what we need to do is to live in the assurance that the God who is in you is greater than any adversity. Awan dapat pagdanagan. Whenever I face adversities and endeavors in life, duwano ko tayo dati puso kong panunod ko kunat. Number one, amok nga ti Apo, dakdakil ng ti anyaman nga rumsuang adversity. Number two, aramidak dati nga ba na kasi confident na blessan ti Apo. I know God will bless this. And if you know that God's hand of blessing is upon it, eh, dapat kakabsat, aramidem. Don't be afraid to do it. Because, blessan ti Apo. Napisa po lang, dakdaktil ti Apo, ngunti anyaman na rumuso ang adversity. God is able, di ba? God is greater than any adversity. So you should not be afraid. Oh. So nga, kada kayong young people, if God is your partner, make your plans big. Hana mabalin nga baybayan na kay tiapo kasi da kayo dagiti agbalin nga key people ti ministry ti HBBC ti masangwanan nga aldaw. Hana kay mabalin nga baybayan ti apo, number one, anak na kayo ti apo. Number two, kayo ang future na key people ng HBBC by the grace of God. Don't be afraid to dare. There may be giants, there may be some people, nalalaing dangam siyak, mas qualified dangam siyak, beam. Kasi no sikat, italagang intuding tiapo kakabsat, talagang sikat itad tiapo. Sikat para ka dayje nga position. The Lord can give it. Amen? Promised land. Oh, promised land. So, hangka nga agambisyon para ti sarili, no di kat agambisyon ka para ti trabaho tiapo. Ako nam Lord, i-prosper nak apo for the sake of the ministry. Oh, kada kay dita Australia, isut ichal challenge ko kada gidi ka kabsat ijayo. Oh, amo ka narigat, adu nga sakripisyo, adu nga puyat, adu nga banog, adu nga liday. Ti sitwasyon di gidi ka kabsat dita ngam idikalman, di Bible study may kat challenge ko ida. Kat ko nakadakwada, aim high for the Lord. If God is your partner, make your plans big. Kadakkelen yo ti agplano. Amen. Oh, so itultuloy ko lang ti Bible study ti Australia kapsat kasi amok nga bendisyon ng ti Apo dahil ti nga panggap. God will bless this. So overcome your fear. Your number one enemy is not the giant. Your enemy is your fear. Ti kalaban tayo kakabsat, haan nga jay problema? Haan nga jay adversity? Ti kalaban tayo jay fear. Because uray kasanot kadakkel na nga gulayat no dati pamatim nga kasken David. Baklatan ni Goliath kakabsat. Gaano mang kalakian, kahit pa 10 Goliaths, if you have the heart and faith of David, you will be able to conquer it. So overcome fear. I hope nga dayto nga message ada natulungan na kada kayo kakabsat. Ha? Ketne crisis, pandemic, the future is uncertain. Ngemti kita iti future hanga digiday parparikot problema. Promise land kakabsat agur uray. Your promise land is waiting for you. Amen. But what you need to do is what? Number one, get rid of Egypt in your mind. Be sold out for God. Kunam Lord, katak dagiti worldliness ti biyag ko, no, dada obsession iti pusok apo nga isuda iti mangyadayo ti pusok ken ka, Lord, ikatak digito itapnon, sold out aklata, dedicated ak, devoted ak, para ken ka. Number two, obey God's leading and instruction. Lord, sa lahat ng connection sa buhay ko, I wanna make sure ma-establish ko ti connection ko ti adipen mo. Da isuna iti mangiwanwan, mangisuro, mangiturong, mangidalan kanya kadagiti sa saom. Amen? Number three, grabsat, be patient. Lord, tulungan na ng makontrol ko iti bagig. Hanlang nga di area ti patience, all aspects. Digijay, last of the flesh, last of the eye, pride of life, lahat yan makontrol. And number four, overcome your fear. Overcome your fear. You have no idea what God can do in your life if you will have the faith like Caleb and Joshua. Let us go up at once, Konada, and possess it, for we are well able to overcome it. Amen? Oh, no glory, no guts, no glory. Amo yung guts kakabsat? Ha? Oh, turud pakinakam. No guts, no glory. So masapul iti panagturud. Amen? Okay, so may the Lord prosper our lives, kakabsat. Kas intayo pa nagserbi iti apo, ta awam makailapad, awam mo't adunga persecution, ken the heads of protection ti apo, dakada tayo. So, awan rason na nga hante, prosper nga kaslaki ni Job, di nga ming kakabsat? Unrivaled prosperity, unrivaled wealth, awan rason na kakabsat nga hante, prosper. God's heads is around us.